That's the meaning of the hadith. Okay. Now going back to your scumbag, that scumbag who is in Pakistan, I don't know what he's doing. So that scumbag, did he appear in Mecca?
Okay. You made the claim and you said 313
the elite of the Muslims.
Go back to the first point.
Of the of the Muslims, yes, yes.
You said the scholars.
Of the, even, yeah, who is the best? Allah says in the Quran, do you know why you say the scholars? Allah says in the Quran, yeah, why I say the scholars? Why I say the scholars? And I'm adamant to say the scholars. Because Allah Azza wa Jalla said in the Quran, that يرفع الله الذين آمنوا والذين أوتوا العلم درجات. Allah will raise the people from those who believes and the one who have the knowledge in status. So the best of the ummah are the scholars. That's why when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he said those are the best of them. That means those are people of knowledge. Going back, going back to the scumbag that you claim. So we finish this. Okay, so listen.
You're running away.
You're going into details. I'm talking about the scumbag that you came back. I'm talking about him. That scumbag who appears in Pakistan. Did he appear in Mecca?
I don't want to talk to you.
Did he appear? Did he appear in Mecca? So that scumbag.
You're being disrespectful.
No, I will be. I will tell you something. I will be disrespectful to every scumbag who comes. Yeah, I will be disrespectful to every scumbag. You know why? I know why. Because one was. Do you know why? Yeah.
Let him finish.
Brother.
Yes.
Yes.
That scumbag who appears in Pakistan. He says he appears. Did he appear in Mecca? No.
You don't listen to the hadith.
Where's the people? No, he doesn't want us. Akhi, even if Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam appear now, he will disbelieve in him.
He's going to give you the hadith.
I will tell you something. Listen. I know. Those people. No. Yeah. They are the best of the people. And the best of this ummah are the scholars. Yes, the scholars. Yours come back. Who appears in Pakistan? That scumbag, that filthy scumbag who appears there. We need to understand, firstly, when he appears there, where is he? Did he appear in Mecca? Mahdi will say, no, that's not me. He will stay away from it. This guy, yes, I'm Mahdi. He is there, he's come back there, doing all these filthy things there, and he is claiming to be Mahdi there. Before he even come to Mecca.
Look at how these people are brainwashed.
Yeah, and brainwashed with someone, uneducated people, someone who is, subhanAllah, someone he doesn't know to, and he say hadith, just to clarify things. The other thing, that's the thing here, why we say this, when someone squeezed with this, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said the 300, those are the best of the ummah. Who is the best of our ummah? Who is the best? علماء that's what Allah عز وجل. Allah says يرفع الله الذين آمنوا منكم والذين أوتوا العلم درجات. Allah will raise those people who believe amongst you and the people of knowledge in status, meaning the one who will say that you are Mahdi, they have knowledge, they are scholars of Islam, they will know you are, he is the Mahdi, not someone who's on the street, a child, you know, wandering around, you know, peeing on himself, and he will say you are the Mahdi. It's not like this.
No, the so, more dreams you have, then you say, I dreamt a lot, he must be the Mahdi. And so, another guy comes to me and says, I dreamt 5 times last night. He's the Mahdi. This is the religion of the dreamers.
So that's why we say those ones, they have the knowledge to affirm he is. Meaning is not about feelings. It's based on knowledge, based on certain things, certain character. And as well, he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by the way, what is the name of the Mahdi? It's Muhammad ibn Abdullah. His name is Muhammad. His father's name is Abdullah.
I wanted his lineage.
Yeah.
But he wouldn't give it.
His father, and he said from the lineage of Al-Hasan. Not what the Shias are saying from Al-Hussein. No, he is from the lineage of Al-Hasan.
He said he's
radiyallahu anhu arda. So that's the meaning of it. And that's why, and by the way, many people will say, what's the importance of them? You need to understand this, yeah? And that's why we say, many people say, Mahdi alayhi salam. Why we say alayhi salam? By the way, he's a man.
Yeah. Okay.
He's a man. He's not Sahabi. By the way, yeah, and the Sahaba is better than him. Yeah, that's for you to know. Muawiyah is better than him. Yeah, let we go far. Yeah, more than that. Yeah, the Sahaba radiallahu anhum is better than him, and he is only the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When he mentioned about indication, he has no special thing except Allah will unite the people under him. That's it. He's not infallible. He will make mistakes. That's why he needs people around him to advise him.
Apparently, according to this imposter in Pakistan who claims to be the Mahdi, the world is going to come to an end in less than 200 years. That means this is an important plea for the social media people who are listening and watching. Do archive this discussion, and 200 years later, we would like your descendants to watch it. and laugh at this imposter, that this was indeed an imposter. Huh? Because when the wall still remains of 200 years, then you know that this was an imposter. 200 years is very short time span. Your grandchild will probably see that day. So do archive this discussion and bring back to the world about this imposter, because by then this imposter will be exposed so bad that they will have no place to hide themselves.
الله المستعان. الله يجزيك الخير. أكرمك الله. جزاك الله خير. أكرمك الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله يرضى عليك. جزاك الله خير. وياك الله. جزاك الله خير. أكرمك الله.
والله
كرم عليك. آمين. الله يبارك فيك. Brothers, who's who's here? I don't know who's.
To check the battery level.
Who's taking the picture?
No, not here. You can't see the battery level. You can see it on there. Okay. Bring it up.
I will speak now, if that's okay.
No one's going to listen because this imposter is exposed. Who's going to give any ear to listen to you?
Okay, fine.
Yeah, speak to the pigeons over there.
This is it. Brother, I'm your Muslim brother. Yeah, don't speak to me like that.
No.
I am your Muslim brother. Don't speak to me like that. I love you for the sake of Allah. I love you for the sake of Allah. Don't speak to me like that.
Don't speak to me like that. I'm your Muslim brother. Don't speak to me like that.
I am your Muslim brother.
We hate you for the sake of Allah.
This is
we love for Allah and we hate for Allah. We hate you. And you scumbag that you follow for the sake of Allah. You do that. No. When you follow a misguided scumbag, you are nuts.
I said to
we hate you for the sake of Allah. We hate you for the sake of Allah. You're not my brother. I'm not your brother.
Listen to me.
You're not your brother. You're not my brother. I'm not your brother.
Should we not remove the pictures from our house?
I am not your brother. You're not my brother. No. You're not my brother. You're not my brother.
Okay, so you've seen this here. Okay, so this is the thing, right? I have been takfir upon today for speaking about Tawheed. Yeah, there are three categories of Tawheed. Okay, Tawheed of Lordship, Tawheed of Wordship, and Tawheed of Names and Attributes. Now, the opposite of Tawheed is Shirk, which is polytheism. And we as Muslims need to do our best to avoid polytheism. We need to do our best to avoid polytheism. Do you understand?
Anyways.
Right?
My brothers need to understand.
Okay, let me ask you a question.
No,
I'm not dealing with a picture of Jesus.
We need to understand that the love and the hate for Allah Azza wa Jal. We love someone for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. We love all the believers for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. And we hate as well for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. Anyone who brings new things to Islam, we hate them for Allah Azza wa Jal. We advise them, we try to bring them back to the truth. As soon as they reject the truth, that's how it is. If they reject the truth, let them do. Follow you whatever you wanted to follow. We, alhamdulillah, we follow Quran and the authentic sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa jazakum Allahu khairan. Salaam alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We done.
جزاك الله خير استاذ
وياك الله يبارك فيك